Titania Blood. A little bit of red there. What can I do? I've got it back on again because I've already gone through a half an hour. I mean, that's how much time I can get involved playing around with the paint, you know. It's just time just flies. No wonder I paint, I love paint. But I like that, you know. I've got to get a little bit of yellow. I want to get a little bit of yellow in amongst there somehow. That's what we need with the yellow mellow. It doesn't look right. I'm losing something there. So what I need is to put a little bit of yellow in there. I don't think it's worked. Oh, it is now. It's starting to come on. I might have to let it dry to do that. It's not bloody working properly, man. Okay, I don't know how far we're even going to go with this, but it gets tedious. But it's all about learning. It's all about learning. And while I'm doing this and going back into these painting, I'm learning. I don't think that colour that I've just put in that trunk there is looking very good. But I reckon a bit of raw sienna, a little bit of violet. And let's just wiggle that around a bit. And I'm thinking this tree here, let's try and take this trunk down a little bit up the top. Up the top here, because a lot of times when you're looking up at that tree, we just see a lot of darkness with the with that stuff. So I'm just going to try and make that darker and just see what it looks like. It could probably even go darker. Try and find another type of brush with a reasonable little bit of hair. 1 hour it'll be that I'll have put in here, and I don't seem to be getting very far. Okay. Just put a little bit of love in your heart, oh yeah. Put a little bit of love in your heart. Art. I just think it's just doing what it's doing, mate. And okay, let's put a little bit of that in there. Obviously, because there's violet in. Let's see. Okay. Okay. Okay, and I'm going to put that around in there too, because that just needs a little bit of that colour in there. Okay, and that's looking good, I reckon. But I'll tell you now that I'm coming into a bit of a negative with it. And that means that I could put it down for an hour or so, or I could put it down till tomorrow. And if I really want to paint, I'll have stuff that I can go back into, because I've always got paintings to work on. I don't have to start, I can start painting if I want to, but I'll always have paintings that I've already started. So, that was a bit nasty, wasn't it? So what we do now, we don't need that. And see when I put that red in there and it's got... No, we're gonna get rid of that. Too serious, that. And yeah, come on. No, I reckon it's coming up all right. But I can't do much to it at the moment. I'm starting to drive into that negative thing with it. I'm just going to put the darks under this. All right. And that can get brought lighter anyhow. And it goes on. I'm not going to do any more to this one tonight. No, it's hard to walk away from it, isn't it? But I'm happy. I'm happy where I've got it. And, you know, I would say tomorrow will come close to really making me a happy man with this painting. That's if it doesn't look good. If the weather looks good, I'll be probably going down to make some frames down the bush. And that'll be what I'll be doing. Okay. I'm not going to do any more to it. That's it for that one. I think it's, I've just come home from a meeting and I've just spent an hour on that painting that's gone flight. I got home at 10:30. It's nearly 11:15 now. In Melbourne, Victoria, Australia. And I think I may make one cup of coffee and then I'm going to head into bed, I think, because I'm liking how this is coming up, though. All this is starting to come alive. If I had a picture of what I Well, I do have, where that was an hour or so ago, three quarters of an hour ago. It's coming alive like that misty one. So, I'm just showing you so you can come through your paint and keep coming through it, and you don't wreck it, providing you don't push the boundaries. You know, as long as you're just playing with your blue, red and yellows, and your white, and something to darken them, burnt umber or something like that, you won't go dirty. You'll work that, my brain will work that painting out as I'm going along. And it will be a magic little pony. So I'm happy with that. I'm happy how that one's gone. And I could show you, I'm really happy the way that Beechworth Baked Me one came up too. It's a lot better than the shitty one I done the other week, a week ago. Well, I'm going to clean these brushes and that's my night. You know, just have a good night, people on the other side of the planet. Have fun. See ya. I think it's nice when it's... It doesn't have to be so powerful, if you know what I mean. But they do have to be very, very close in colour. Okay. And yellow, mellow. I don't know what I'm going to do here. Okay. A bit of yellow in there though. Well, just gotta play around with it and get it cooked. Okay. Not getting very far with this stuff at this stage, but it doesn't matter. It does not matter. What we'll do is we will get there eventually. We'll play a little bit of that stuff. I'll put a little bit of what are we going to use? A little bit of ultramarine, a little bit of sap green, and a little bit of red of some description. And then we're just going to put those darks in again. So, and then we're going to put this one in here. Right, now I've got to have a look at that, see what I can do with this. Because that's got to come down there, okay. That's going to eat in there, that's going to come in there. And let's get a little bit of a smudge going there. And you can feel the paint pulling. So, I was using this paint earlier today now, the liquid that's been in the paint is starting to tack up a bit. And so when it does, it's good for water because I can feel the drag. I can feel the drag on the brush. And I can feel that drag on the brush. So that makes it feel good. I'll leave that there for a minute because what we need to do just play around a little bit with the tops of these trees. Alright, so I get a bit of sap green, a little bit of red, and that's cad red, I think. And it looks alright, it looks good, it's working. Thank you.
that's looking good. That's looking good.
You see this going over paintings all the time. I'm actually still learning myself about some different colours that I've just used there. And I think that Georgina, or what Georgian Cad Red, is better than the Art Spectrum Cad Red. And some of those paints, or I don't think they're cheaper, but some of the old paints that I used to use when I was a little kid are really, really bloody beautiful colours, you know. I've got a cad red deep, which is beautiful. I think it's that that's in this actually. And okay, we're going to take this down here and. Whack a little bit of red in it, into the blue, a little bit of orange, and that'll give me a nice little bankage at a distance down the back there. Yeah, that's good. And that might even take a little tiny bit of that colour in there too. And we might even do that here. It's just to mute it a little bit, because it's in the shade a little bit, so it doesn't want to be dead, but it doesn't want to be too bright, you know what I mean? That's alright. And that's alright there too. Oops. Anyhow, that is looking good, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to try and play a little bit of that bank stuff that I've just put in there. I might even just weigh a little bit out in the water, you know, just to. Looking good. You'll know when you work, when your paint's working, because I'm not joking, you'll feel good when it's happening. But it's also like when you've been painting for a long time, it's the control of the white and the darks. Control of that white. And if you don't have control of that white, yeah. So now I'm just flickering that small, the spatula over the top. That's one way of doing those little edges. Right. And the other way is to cut in with the brush. And that may put a little bit of liquid or a little bit of oil on my paintbrush. Clean the paintbrush. Get a bit of that clean stuff in there. And then go for it. See how you can lift that off. And you can lift that off there. Pull that down. Time goes quick when you're having fun. Get those things in there and pull that paint off. And we just play with the paint, and it's like elastic or like a real thick gluey type stuff. Mm-hmm. All right, that's looking nice. What do we do? Put a little bit of ultramarine down here, make it a little bit darker ultramarine. And just leave it at that.
Well, I like to put the wattle in. Have that wattle, that bluey wattle. I can't keep away from when I'm painting the Murray. That's what I see. That's what I see as an artist. So I want another artist to see things different. But that's how I see it. So sometimes I don't give myself credit, you know. I think, oh no, that's not right, but you know, that's maybe not what other people do, but I like it myself. It's, you know, it's nice. If it makes me, if it's giving me a buzz, it's working. Simple as that. You don't get a buzz out of it, it's not working, you won't even paint. The idea is to get a buzz out of it. And I do. And I'm just thinking, putting little lines, you know.